Okay, this is EA Road. That's Cahoe right there. So, this is the house. Right on the left. See, there's no garage. That's the roof right there. And it's on the Mackay side of the street. And steps going down. So you can see there's a catchment tank right there. There's the house. Beautiful views. And definitely, I'm not seeing any power lines at all because it's so steep. It drops off really steeply behind this house. So the next road is way below, so there are no power lines in the view. This is, I think, probably the only street that has this. You know, they wouldn't have any power lines. Might be one other in here, but some neighbors. Okay, I'll see if I can take a look at the house now. I think the agent's in there. Built the house so that there's a nice sitting area on this side of the house. The rock walls are terraced. Catchment tank here. And this nice little landscaping, the little avocado tree here. So the steps goes down to a lower level. Storage. And this might have potential for a lap pool. You could put one of those above ground pools with decking around it. Right here, have a little lap pool. Right across here. It's a red roof down there. No one's built on the south side here. That would be the neighbor's property. This looks like it goes down to a little unit down below the house on this side. I think there's the agent showing it to another buyer right now. I'll just kind of start filming here, and this is Lance, the listing agent. Oh wow, look at this, vertigo. Yeah, it just drops. All the way south view. Nice big lanai. Put a table out here.
That's interesting too. Today, Rich, you can see the boat in the harbor.
Oh wow! Look at
the bay
that.
And the Cahoe.
Yeah, you can see all the way to Kona. There's actually a cruise ship in the harbor you can see from here. Wow, this is a great view. I think the best view I've seen in this neighborhood. Nice neighbors, nice homes. No one's built on either side. And the only power lines are down here, the next street, well below your view. Yeah. Wow, this is a nice view. And this is tongue and groove, open beam ceiling, tiled flooring, like 12-inch, 13-inch tiles. There's a slider here, little utility closet, and another slider right here, and another one here, windows all around. Here the kitchen, got a big counter here, wooden counter with, it's like a, I'm not sure what that is.
It's actually concrete.
Concrete countertop. Got the, yeah, they did concrete countertops. Strange, isn't it? Oh, I think this is painted Formica on this side, and then probably concrete here.
Yeah, you know, I'm feeling that. I think you're right.
Yeah, I think that's unknown on the counters, but nice. Okay. Yeah, it's nice space. Big open ceilings. This is there's a sort of a pocket set of pocket doors here, or not sure, they're not probably not pocket doors, but no, they're not. They slide open. There's a bedroom here with the ocean view. They have it covered up because you probably get some late afternoon sun there. Tile shower with like a fiberglass material pan. Nice pocket door. This is the bathroom. Hallway goes to the front of the house. There's a bedroom here. The bedrooms all have sliding glass doors, which is nice, with beautiful ocean views from the beds. Closet. Okay, we'll move on to the third bedroom. This is the third bedroom, same thing, sliding glass door. And not sure about that flooring. Laminate, it's a laminate, yeah, you can tell. Small catchment tank, not a real big catchment tank, but it can be fixed. Views from all the rooms. And the common bath here. Formica countertops, drop-in sinks, tile showers. This one has a tub. Looks like it's in good shape. tile in the hallway. 12 inch tile. Access to the attic. You enter the blinds are closed, but if you had these blinds open, it'd just be a panoramic ocean view. It's amazing that you do have a view all the way to Kailua Bay. And even beyond, actually, I can see past it. It's amazing. Okay, we'll take a look downstairs. The back here. Yeah, this would be, you can put one of those splash pools. You know, they're like the mirror, that vinyl or whatever the material is.
Oh, yeah.
Really strong. And have like a little decking around it. Have a nice lap pool. Okay, we're gonna go downstairs and take a look.
You can leave your shoes on then.
Oh yeah, look at this, storage under the house.
Yeah, lots of storage.
Yeah, it's, they built it. Nice storage spot here. All under the house. Lighting, or clothesline. Yeah, neat little area. Oh wow, look at this. This is kind of unfinished space here. Under the house, and wow, it's got a bathroom.
So there's room for a tub and stuff over here with the plan.
Mm-hmm.
A bathtub and a shower over here.
Yeah.
And then kind of a walk-in closet in here too.
Put
the dresser in here. So if you notice, if I can just point out real quick that sure. All this, they left all this open.
Yeah.
So they could get it permitted.
Right. Okay.
So it's all completely unpermitted, and that's why you see extension cords, just because he wanted to eventually do it right and get it permitted.
Right.
So his son was coming out though, and they had to build something fast. So they put this together, and the permitting was gonna be later. And they
kind of laid some carpet down and some open. These are true open beam ceilings. And it's got a big covered lanai down here. And look at that. Sliders. Let me make sure. Oh, there we go. Okay. Yeah, so this is the steps. Lower level here. Same view as above.
It's incredible, yeah.
Yeah.
Usually you get down here and it's...
Yeah. And the property line's probably down where those papaya trees are.
Yep, pretty much. You can see a stake. Come over here, Rich. You can see the bottom corner stake over there.
That's right. Just beyond those papayas, you can see the stake. Okay. Wow. Yeah, this is cool. This is the room down here, the bedroom. They put some window, screen. It's screened in there. And a bed. Some little louvered doors. Slider. Kind of a nice size space. Okay, well that's it. There's screen right there. Nice and airy down here, actually.
Beautiful.
Right before you come into this this room down here. Steps come down. There's another storage area behind this, locked off behind this door, about the same size as this laundry room. And and I guess some banana trees. I guess that explains the where they hang the laundry right there. Okay, that's it. That's it. Yeah, nice footings down here with braces, metal braces attached. Looks solid. Plenty of room, Lance was saying, underneath. There's like a story and a half if you wanted to add more square footage below the house.
One of the things to note too is in the new CCNRs with the tanks, they have to be either under the house or camouflage somehow.
Okay.
The existing tanks. So there's plenty of room to do a couple of tanks under there if they wanted more than what they have up there.
Got it. So if they were to leave it where it is now, they would need to camouflage it somehow.
That one's contracts on it.
I see. So that's Aloha. It's a antenna for Aloha Broadband. Roof was just resealed recently.
Repainted.
Yeah, and the Aloha Broadband, so they get free internet and $100 a month?
$100
a month on top of that for allowing them to have that on top of the roof.